The increase in cases of gully sites in Gombe State is becoming an issue of concern. It is for this reason that the National Project Coordinator of Nigeria Erosion and Watershed Management embarks on a tour of affected sites in the state.
The consultant, together with the contractor, came up with a plan to reduce the completion period by more than 50%. It's now down to about 7 months instead of 18 months. That is almost shedding off 60%.
At the moment, there are four gully sites in the state, with the biggest spanning 2.7 kilometers, affecting the state's university, Malam Ina, and Kagarawal communities.
Gombe, I want to say, is the second largest gully erosion state in Nigeria, apart from Anambra State. Initially, we submitted about 45 active gullies to the World Bank. And because of time and funds and constraints, they were only able to approve five. So far, we finished designs of two. We have already started implementation on one. This is what we are, where we are today. We will move to the other one that will start soon.
Gombe State government officials explain their involvement in terms of funding, monitoring and planning.
It is with this support that our governor, the green governor, would be able to pursue more projects, especially the rest of the four sites which are in NUMAP and possibly in another project in, under the Ministry of Environment, which will be forthcoming, inshallah.
For us, this is not just a project about, you know, taking care of a gully. It is about restoring livelihoods, and this is firmly in line with what is reflected inside Devagom. And Devagom, as you know, is aligned with the Sustainable Development Goals. By the time you take care of livelihood, you're already taking care of goal one and two of Sustainable Development Goals.
Although NUMAP assures that it would complete the project ahead of the rains, as well as begin work on other sites around the state government pledges more support to enable the federal government to match words with action.